You are listening to Be Inspired with Bishop Alvaro. The program is about to start. Get ready. This is the 16th day of the fast of Daniel.
Welcome to Be Inspired, and yes, today is the 16th day of the 21 days fast of Daniel, and we are right now in the week of preparation. Yes, this is the preparatory week for the great day, the day of the marriage of the Lamb, my marriage with God. What about you? Huh? Is this going to be your marriage with God? So type there, my marriage with God. And by the way, where is your wedding ring? I prepared here my wedding ring. It's here. As you know, for 7 days, we're not going to be wearing our wedding rings. We who are married, and you who are single, but you acquired your ring. So you're going to wear it on the great day, on the 23rd, when you are seeking God. And as you experience Him, many of you will be baptized in the Holy Spirit. Then you're going to put the ring on your finger to officialize, to make your relationship with God official. And you're going to say to Him, Lord, I'll never leave you. He doesn't need to say that to you because He said it already. Huh? Yes, He said that He's going to stay with you, with us, always. But you, myself, we are going to say, Lord, I'm going to stay with you all the way. And I know you're going to look after me as you promised. So have your rings ready there. As you know, this is part of the daily tasks. In the morning and in the evening, we're going to be presenting our rings to God, consecrating them. And we are doing this in preparation for the great day, the 23rd of August. This coming Sunday, look how amazing. This coming Sunday, especially at 10 a.m. in all of our UCKGs across the United Kingdom and also all over the world. And if you are listening to me, if you're watching us from abroad, outside the UK, look for a UCKG near you and go there. Make this day your great day, the day of the marriage of the Lamb, your marriage with God. I will play that video once again. What an amazing video. We have that one from Negev, right? Amazing. We played yesterday at the end of the program. We played Sunday in our service. And in case you missed it, I believe it's important to play again today, because I want you to see what God wants to do with everyone. God wants each one of us, no matter our past, no matter what you have done with your life, whether you have believed in Him or not, no matter your past, the moment we come to His house and we receive the message and we accept it, you're going to see there with this video, through this video, what God intends to do with every single person in the planet, no matter their nationality, if they're male or female, it doesn't matter. That's God's desire. This is God's will for every single human being to become a fountain of living waters. Yes, that's what God wants to do in everybody's life. But the problem is not everyone is willing to allow Him to work in their lives. Not everyone, I can even say, is thirsty for Him. Many people are thirsty for the waters of this world. They want the pleasures of this world. And as long as they keep focusing on the world, God is unable to turn the desert into an oasis. As you're going to see there, this powerful event that takes place on the region of the Negev. It's a desert there in Israel. I know some of you have watched already, but I know it's going to be great to watch again. So I'm going to be playing this video for you all right now. And as you watch this video, believe that that's going to be your experience with God this coming Sunday. This coming Sunday, God is going to turn deserts into oases. Yes, lives that are dry, you know, maybe certain areas of your life, they are arid, there is no fruit, there is no life. But the moment you receive the Holy Spirit, the living waters will produce much fruits in you for the glory of God. So let's share the link of the program with more people. And yes, look at that. Thank you for the reminder. Before I forget, prepare your papers and documents for them to be presented during the prayer. Okay? Thank you very much. As you can see there, they reminded me there. And today we're going to be blessing your projects, your plans, and we're going to be determining that. This week is going to be a week of great success for all of you. Let's invite more people to join us. Come on. Share the link libertyradio.co.uk with more people. If you have done it already, let's continue sharing. If you haven't done it, go ahead and do it. Repost everything we posted online. And let's enjoy this marvelous video that was, you know, whoever made it for sure was inspired by the Holy Spirit. Yes, it was our TV crew that prepared this special video. And I'm sure as you watch it, the Holy Spirit is going to show you now what He intends to do in you.
The interior of a person without the Holy Spirit is like an arid and unwelcoming desert that has no life. However, there is hope for you whose life has been like this desert. The same thing that God does in the Negev desert. In the south of Israel, the Negev is a desert region most known for its dryness. However, when the rains arrive, the mountains become full of water. And in overflowing, they form torrents that descend the mountains towards the Negev. They invade the desert and fill every empty space. Transforming what was dry into a garden with the most beautiful flowers. Bring back our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. Now, imagine this river overflowing inside you. This is what happens with those who are thirsty for the Holy Spirit. Their souls are completely flooded, and what used to be a dry and empty life becomes completely full with the presence of God. That person becomes a gushing fountain for eternal life.
I don't get tired watching this video. Amazing. This is what God, our God, intends to do in everyone's life. All people have to do is this, to be thirsty for Him, to desire that, because that will not happen automatically. We need to do our part, and God is going to do His. You're going to see now in the testimonies, brand new testimonies, by the way, from another pastor and another pastor's wife. Very, very nice testimonies. They're going to help many people today. You see that they had to do their part. And even the intention, if the intention, you may be seeking, but if the intention is not right, you're not going to experience the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We're going to watch today two testimonies from another pastor, another pastor's wife. And it's going to be the testimony from Pastor Morris and his wife Audrey. And I'm sure as you watch both testimonies, yes, you're going to notice many differences there. But both of them experienced the great moment, the baptism in the Holy Spirit. You're going to get to know more about their past as well, what they went through, especially Audrey as well. You're going to know more about what she faced in life. And this is going to be good for you to see, for you to arrive at this conclusion. If God was able to bless her and change her life, he can change mine. Because I'm quite sure, I'm pretty sure that Audrey suffered more than many of you who are watching there. So let's watch Pastor Morris's testimony. And straight after his, we're going to be watching his wife's, Audrey. So wherever you are, if there are people there next to you washing the dishes, call them there. If there is somebody there next to you in the bedroom next to you, just tell them, look, 5 minutes, come and watch two amazing testimonies. I'm sure that they're going to help them as well. Let's watch it.
I always wanted to receive the Holy Spirit. When I heard the pastors preaching about it, I wanted to know the Holy Spirit. If people would tell me to go to the top of the church and on the roof, I would do it. If they would tell me, go to the toilet and seek in the toilet, I would do it. Whatever people tell me to do this, I would do it. But I didn't receive the Holy Spirit, and I didn't know why. I was trying to find out what was wrong with me, what was wrong, why I didn't receive the Holy Spirit. And one day, there was a special event where the pastor called the youth group, and then he was talking to them, and he said, listen, what God wants is for you to be of God. Not what you do, but who you are. And then I went home thinking, who am I? Who is Morris? And then I saw that I was someone who would pretend. I would try to please everybody. I would be a person that everything that I would do thinking of what people are thinking of me. And when I was seeking the Holy Spirit, I was doing the same. Because I was thinking, I have to receive the Holy Spirit because the assistant know me, the member already received, my brother already received the Holy Spirit. I need to receive the Holy Spirit because of that. But then that day, I thought, no. I need to know God. I need to receive Him, not because of other people, but because of me. And then truly on that day, I emptied myself and I presented myself to God, not repeating words in my prayer, but saying who I was. And after that meeting, we were coming back. It was in the main branch. We were coming back home in the bus. And then in the bus, a group of people went to the back and started seeking the Holy Spirit. And then I joined them in that group and then started seeking the Holy Spirit as well. And then the person who was leading the seeking of the Holy Spirit, she stopped and she said, listen, God wants to come inside of you. And I said, my God, this is it. It's now. It's today. I want your Spirit. And that's when He came upon me there inside of the bus. I was in the bus, but for me, I was not there anymore. There was a group of people, but for me, it was just me and Jesus. What a day for me. The day that my life changed. And from there on, the desire to save souls, to bring people to God, grew in me so much. And 21 years ago, I was called to do this work. And what a privilege is to be here today. I have my wife with me. God brought her to my life to help me in this work of saving souls. And I'm going to keep on going all the way.
Look how amazing. He received the Holy Spirit in the bus. In the bus. That means the place is irrelevant. No matter where you are. As long as you make that place your sanctuary. Like many of you today, if you make your place your sanctuary and you surrender yourself to God there where you are, God is going to come upon you there where you are as well. Something important that Pastor Morris mentioned, this is the situation of quite a few people. He was seeking God not with the right reasons. See, he wanted the Holy Spirit because he didn't want to be the one who didn't have the Holy Spirit, if you know what I mean. He didn't want to be left out because people had the Holy Spirit, you know, people around him, and he wanted the Holy Spirit for that reason. But when he decided to receive the Holy Spirit, to seek him, because he wanted to know him, he wanted to know the real God. So when the intention was right, God manifested his power in a very unusual way, or he came upon him in a very unusual place. Tell me, how many people you know who have received the Holy Spirit inside of a bus? Well, no matter the place, as long as you make that place your sanctuary, as long as you focus on God, he will come upon you. I know of people who received the Holy Spirit as they were in the truck. Imagine, I remember a truck driver. He was driving and the background music was on and he was praising, worshiping, and then he experienced the baptism of the Holy Spirit. He had to park, stop his truck, get off the truck, and he started praising, worshiping God. It was so amazing. You know, quite a few years ago, I believe it's about 20 years ago, it was one of the first testimonies I ever watched when I came to church. I know of people who received the Holy Spirit in the kitchen. Imagine, in the bathroom, they were there saying, "Lord, I need you now. I want you now." They gave themselves to God and said, "I want you, not for personal merit, because personal gain. I don't want you to brag about it. Oh, now I have the Holy Spirit. I want you because I need you. It's a matter of survival. Without you here, I'm not going to make it. I want to serve. I want to obey. I want to be with you today until the rest of my life and forever." And they were there expressing themselves, and the Holy Spirit came upon them in the bathroom, in the toilet. And today, as we are saying, he can come upon you wherever you are. But make sure your intentions are genuine. They are according to God's will. Some people, they want the Holy Spirit because they want to speak in tongues. That's not the purpose. Remember, we need the Holy Spirit because the Holy Spirit is going to play a great role, an important role in our lives when it comes to remaining saved. Are you getting this? Once you know you are saved, now it's a matter of urgency receiving the Holy Spirit. It's not something secondary. It's not something that you leave for tomorrow. Because as long as you live in this world, okay, you are saved, you gave your life to Jesus, but if you have not yet been baptized in the Holy Spirit, you are at risk. You can lose your salvation. You're going to face moments of trials, tribulations, and the Holy Spirit's going to be crucial. Crucial in those moments, yes, to guide us, direct us, to sustain us, to help us, to face them and overcome them as well. So today we're going to be seeking, and you can be sure you can experience him, the baptism, today. Yes, some people are receiving the Holy Spirit before the 23rd. If today you give your life to Jesus, for sure today he is going to bless you. And before we watch Audrey's testimony, please hold in your hands there your papers, your documents, your purse, your wallet, something that represents your finances. Before I continue, let me bless everything now so we can watch the next testimony and move on with the program until we reach the seeking of the Holy Spirit. So close your eyes, hold everything in your hands. Let's pray in agreement now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to bless their plans and projects, everything they have in their hands, and those who don't have anything but they are joining me. Bless the work of their hands. Let this week be a week of great success. Let them have victory in everything. Those who are going to go for tests, those who are going to go for their interviews, enlighten their minds, give them victory there. If that's your will, my Lord, may the doors now be open and let them take possession of what they are determining it will be theirs. We bless the work of their hands. Everything they will be doing, let it be successful, my Lord. In Jesus' name, we determine their victory now. The doors are open for your people. And this week will be a week of great victory for them. You make a difference in their lives. I determine, and those who agree say amen. Yes. Remember to be faithful to God. Don't get involved with lies, dodgy works, and Remember to return to God your first fruits, because if you want God to honor you, first decide to honor Him. So whatever form of income that comes to your hands this week and every day of your life, first, the first thing you have to do is to separate the first 10% and return to God and believe He is going to honor you. Let's watch now Audrey's testimony. Another amazing testimony. You're going to see what she went through in life. You're going to hear something about her health as well, health issues she faced, and also her experience with the Holy Spirit. Let's see it.
I came actually when I was really in a point that medically there was no hope for me anymore. I was in a coma for 6 days. I was, you know, on life support, and that was what brought me to the church. And when I came to the church, I began to use my faith. I began to seek God. I began to learn that the Holy Spirit was important and He was the most, you know, the priority for me. After a while, I realized I was seeking in the wrong way, because I was seeking God out of the gratitude of my heart, out of the miracle that He's done for me and the transformation of my physical life. But I didn't know how it was to really love God. God began to show me things inside of me that was kind of like not pleasing Him. There was pride, there was also a bit of bitterness, because, you know, I was brought up by my grandparents, and I had this bitterness towards my parents, and, you know, thinking that they had abandoned me and left me with them, that they didn't care for me. So all these things I had to resolve within myself and with people around me first. And then naturally after that, it was quick to receive the Holy Spirit. I started listening to, you know, the pastor, what he was saying about how we can get closer to God, how we should be focusing on having a relationship with God and knowing the Holy Spirit. I was just, you know, I was just there seeking the Holy Spirit. I went up in front, and it was like, it was just me and God alone. It was like a movie that was playing in front of me. He showed me how much He loved me, how He was there in the moments that, you know, that it was, I thought I was alone. I realized that that's it. I just had to surrender. And from then on, that surrender, He was there with me. He came, He lived in me. And from that day on, it was never the same. So today, my life is on the altar. I'm married to a man of God. We're both serving God on the altar. And it's a life of continuous sacrifice and continuous surrender. But this is amazing, because there's no other place that I'd rather be than to be on the altar of God.
Amazing testimony. And yes, Audrey, there is no better place than the altar, indeed. And I want to die on the altar. Ah, if I could be buried on the altar, you know what I mean? You know, spending my last second on this world on the altar. Ah, it would be great. As you saw there, she suffered in life. She had terrible issues in the past. Her health, she was on a coma, right? She was on a coma for a couple of days. But as you saw there, she overcame. She received the Holy Spirit, and she is today being used by God to inspire people, to inspire you. Did you hear what she said? She surrendered. It's about surrender. Yes, surrender your life. Detach yourself from everything and everyone. Make Him your priority. And you know when God is your priority, by your choices, huh? Your actions show what is your priority. Yes, so make sure that God becomes your number one priority. Obey Him. Please Him. Abandon what separates you from Him. And He is going to honor you. He is going to bless you. For sure. He wants you to become a living proof of His power, a fountain of living water yourself. Yes, He wants people to look at you and see His image and likeness there. He wants you to become this fountain of peace, of joy. He wants people to see God Himself in you. We're going to be seeking God in a moment. Let's just have a look on the tasks of the day. Let's go before we seek the Holy Spirit. Today is day 16. If you have the task there, good. If you don't, we're going to be placing there on your screen right now. Let's see there. Body. Exercise even if you don't feel like it. Keep it up during this final week. Come on, let's go. Soul. Therefore, whatever you want man to do to you, do also to them. And the task. Do you need to apologize to anyone? Do you? So do it today. And by the way, have you invited your guests for this Sunday? So pick up an invite at your local UCKG. So as you can see my hands here, this is the invite. Pass by any UCKG and you can collect this leaflet so you can invite your guests, invite people who will also experience God with you this Sunday. Don't forget, in every wedding we have the guests, we have the best man, the who of honor?
Maid of honor,
right? So make sure that you invite them to be there with you. And look how amazing. They're going to have the opportunity of themselves becoming the bride. Can you imagine? You go to a wedding and you can become the bride. That's how amazing this Sunday will be. All those will come thirsty for God. All those will come to this special ceremony. As they open their hearts to God, as they surrender themselves, they are going to experience God like never before. The outpouring of the Holy Spirit, and it's going to be worldwide. So pass by in UCKG. If you want to know more about addresses, go to uckg.org/addresses. And I'm going to be here in Finsbury Park this Sunday at 10 a.m. That's our address, 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London, N43NX. We are in London, as you can see there. So don't forget, you can get as many as you want, as many as you need, actually, if you're going to invite more than one person. But I believe each one of us, we can bring a soul this Sunday. What pleases God more than souls coming to His house? Seeing us bringing souls to His house. So this Sunday, let's go to the last one, Spirit. Meditate on this passage, Hebrews 10:19-25. So let's see here, Hebrews. Let's go there together. Hebrews 10:19-25. Let me go here with you. Yes. So it says there. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which He consecrated for us through the veil, that is His flesh, and having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for He who promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Let's read the slides there about the enter the Holy of Holies. No human offering or action could achieve the high privilege of entering the heavenly sanctuary. Few men were able to enter the Holy of Holies on earth. Only the high priests had this privilege to represent the multitude that were outside the sanctuary. He carried 12 stones that represented the 12 tribes of Israel on his breastplate. the access that had never been given to anyone, not even the prophets, look at that, that were highly regarded by God, was now granted to everyone through the blood of the Lord Jesus. Contrary to the fear that was once felt when approaching the sanctuary because of the holiness of the place in the new covenant, we are encouraged to have boldness. Therefore, we can boldly come before the throne of the Most High, having confidence that the blood of His beloved Son has forgiven, justified, and sanctified us. Let's see the task there. Look at that. Divorce the world. Yes. Before you can, you know, have your wedding day, get married with God, you have to divorce the world and its practices once and for all. If you have already done this, so continue sanctifying your life. Stay away from the pollution of this world. And in the morning, don't forget, and in the evening, consecrate the ring you will wear on the 23rd of August, the marriage of the Lamb. Let's go for a quick break and prepare your rings. And when we come back from the break, we're going to be seeking God and also consecrating. We're going to be consecrating our rings here, preparing ourselves for the great day of the marriage of the Lamb. We'll be right back.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Millions of people all over the world are getting prepared for this day. The day of your covenant with God. Let us be glad and rejoice and give Him glory, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and His wife has made herself ready. On the last day of the fast of Daniel, we will have the day of the marriage of the Lamb. A unique day for those who want an eternal commitment with the Lord Jesus and are thirsty to know Him personally. For this day, prepare your best clothes, whether new or you already own. Also, acquire a ring you can afford to buy or use the one from your wedding day. That ring will be put on your finger after receiving the baptism with the Holy Spirit to seal your covenant with the Lord Jesus. The day of the marriage of the Lamb, the day of your covenant with God. Sunday, 23rd August at 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London, N4 3NX, or at any Universal Church near you.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
So let us now have our moment of intimacy with God. No matter where you are, today you saw a testimony from someone who was baptized with the Holy Spirit in the bus. So make your place your sanctuary. And remember, what God wants to see now is not the place. He wants to see a sincere desire inside of you to know Him, to serve Him, to please Him. If God sees that you are thirsty for Him, you are detaching yourself from whatever separates you from Him, and you are making Him your priority, He is going to reveal Himself to you there where you are. So let's seek Him with all of our hearts. Close your eyes there where you are, if you can. Join me now, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, we make our places our sanctuaries. I'm making this studio now my sanctuary. I know You are here. You are there where these people are. We are gathered together in Your name. And I'm sure, Lord, as they surrender themselves to You now, You will come to take over this life. So as they empty themselves, as they ask You to forgive them, to cleanse them, do it now, my Lord. Wash away their sins. take away from them what is not yours, and as they show a sincere desire, intention to know you, to please you, reveal yourself to them. Whoever you are, pour out your heart there, empty yourself, and believe today you're going to be filled with the living waters. Be cleansed, be washed, be forgiven right now. Whoever you are, your past cannot now affect you anymore. Now lift up your face, lift up your hands, and just believe. Jesus is there with you. And now, as you believe, as you make Him your priority, be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Be filled with the living water. Maybe your life was like the desert of Negev until today, dry, no life. But now you become an oasis, you become a fountain of water, living water. Yes, He comes upon you, He renews you, He revives you. Wherever you are, you can praise Him, you can worship Him now, adore Him. Go ahead, continue giving more of yourself, and you're going to experience more of God there where you are. Worship you, our Lord, our Master, our Father, our Savior. Be glorified. Ah, my Lord, make us better for you. Every single day, inspire us. What do you want from us? How can we please you more? And every day as we continue preparing ourselves for the great day, this Sunday, our marriage, Lord, reveal to us whatever you want. Help us to do what is right, to make right choices this week, my Lord. That's what we want. And not only this week, we want from now on, as of now, to be better for you, my Lord. We want to be better for you tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow to be even better. Shape us, mold us, continue working us, my Lord. Please, all of you now, hold in your hands the ring. Let's consecrate it before we finish our program. Lift it up in your hands. If you don't have the ring, but you're going to acquire one, lift up your hands with us as well. My Lord, we ask you to bless this ring. Consecrate it. This is the element, the object that we represent our covenant with you. Those who are married, those who are single. This Sunday, my Lord, all of us will put it on rejoicing, because we're going to put it on after we have experienced you, after we have received that assurance that you are with us. Many, after they have been baptized, they're going to put it on, my Lord. Ah, it's going to be a total renewal, a renewal of vows. Those who have never made a vow with you, they will do it. And those who broke their vows with you, those who divorced you, but now they are divorcing the world, they are coming back to you. I know it's going to be, my Lord, a remarkable moment for them. Their covenants will be restored. Bless it, Lord. Every day we're going to be consecrating these rings in the morning, in the evening, here on the radio, in the evening with your servants. Continue blessing us, my Lord. Protect and guard us. Deliver us from all evil, my Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. It's blessed. Don't forget to acquire your ring, eh? If you don't have yours. And you who are married, you can consecrate your wedding ring, okay? Every single day, I'm going to be here with you in the evening, every single day, presenting our rings to God. And tomorrow, we're going to post new tasks on the blog. Have a look there on the link, alvarolima.com. And also, you can go to the other links there, to Bishop's blog, Bishop Macedo's blog. We have Univer, the website of the church. As you can see there, those addresses will lead you to spiritual contents that will continue strengthening you, blessing you abundantly. So I'm going to let you go now. See you tomorrow here once again. And in the church as well, 7 a.m., 10 a.m., 3 p.m., and 7:30 p.m., we're going to be praying for God to bless your family members. Actually, we're going to be determining your healing and the healing of your family members. Don't forget tomorrow also to have your water ready. We're going to be blessing here on the radio together with you. And in any UCKG, it's going to be healing day. And also in every church, we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit. You who decided to come every day, great. You who cannot come every day to church, come as often as you can. Add one or two more days until the great day, Sunday. Have a wonderful day, afternoon or evening. See you tomorrow here once again at 10 p.m. Bye-bye.
I am weary from the waves crashing over every day. God of mercy, please come rescue me. I am longing for your voice, gentle whisper in the noise. Father, tell me everything's alright. Your power and your presence breaks strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. You alone can take my scars, piece by piece restore my heart. Take what's broken, make it whole again. In your power and your presence, break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. Oh, there will be breakthrough. Shake the mountains, break the walls apart, open the heavens. Almighty God, you are overcomer, defender of my heart. And by your power, the oceans open wide. Your fire falls down, heaven and earth collide. King Jesus, forever by my side. Your power and your presence breaks strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. Your power and your presence breaks strongholds,
Today is the 16th day of the Fast of Daniel. For he whom God has sent speaks the words of God, for God does not give the Spirit by measure.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.